Hey friends, welcome back to Tech DIY. So today we are going to see one important feature. So what if we can have multiple services and all the services point to a server which will provide or inject the properties into them instead of having their own properties with locally at their resources folder? What if we can have something called config service or a config service which refreshes the properties even though the application is not yet restarted? Yes guys, so that's what we can achieve with cloud config server. So this diagram, as you can see, we are going to have a config server, and then we are going to have services. Multiple services can be there, so all those services will be referring to that particular config server, and then that config server would be having the locations. It may be a Git, it may be a local file system, or it may be a vault. So that's what we are going to cover today. And for this tutorial, what we have followed is spring.io, and in spring.io there is a link. This link we are following for cloud config, and then there is we followed building also, but mainly we have focused and followed this link in spring.io. There is a tutorial on spring centralized configuration, so we are going to look into that. So you can also open that, and description, this will be provided in the description section. Okay, so at any point of time you can go to there and you can see. So without further ado, let's get started. So let's see what and all things we are going to need for this POC. So for this we will be needing two things. One is config server and the other is config client. So to add a config server, we need to have in the start.spring.io we need to add the dependency config server. So that we need to add, and here as you can see in the pom.xml, this is the effective pom.xml after you take the project. So here here we have added the enabled the cloud config dependencies in the dependency management, as well as added the Spring Cloud config server. Okay, so that's what we are showing. So as you can see, this is a very good tutorial guys, step by step tutorial. It is showing what and all things are needed. As you can see, this particular POM which I'm showing is for client. So for client, in client also we need to add that, and this is the Gradle for that. So both the configurations are here present in this tutorial, so you can follow that. And then for settings config server, we need to have add enable config server, and that's what it is. And we need to refer the application.properties, or we can have application.yaml also. Okay, and then it is this tutorial provide end to end things. I mean, each and everything are there, so you can refer that. And we are going to do an POC today based on this tutorial itself. What we are going to do apart from that is, instead of as I said, in locations, so what we are going to refer for this tutorial is the simplest approach, wherein we will be storing the properties, common properties, into the location where the config server look for properties would be. In our case, we are referring the file system, local file system. So that approach is called native approach. Okay, so that's what we are going to do. And for native approach, we also referred one more tutorial, that is Spring Cloud Config Server tutorial. So that's the first tab, as you can see in the browser, Safari browser. So that's pretty much of it. And we are just reading that again. I mean, what as you can see on the screen, these configurations would be needed to just refresh the service, actual service. So as whatever change has happened with just that refresh endpoint, our service will pick up those changes even without restarting the service. So that's the magic of actuator, and that also we will cover into this tutorial. And at refresh scope we need to provide, and then that's pretty much of it. To refresh the application, we will be using this curl command. And we will be hitting this curl command. So every time we hit this curl command, what happens is that it will refresh our service with the new values which are changed in the config server location. So our application starts reading those values once we refresh, once we hit this refresh button. So that's the magic. We don't need to restart our service. And this is how it will work. And as I said earlier also, we are referring this Spring Cloud's config server, and we are going to do file system backend. So in file system backend, we will be doing those configurations. So we need to set the profile as native. Let's see in the code. So here we have added, we are showing the config server application or config server service, we can say. So we have put at enable config server annotation at the application class, and here are the dependencies which we effect. This is the effective form, and here are the dependencies which are coming. So it is cloud config server, and in dependency management, we are adding the artifacts, Spring Cloud artifacts. So that's what we have added here in the effective dependencies. So this is it. And now the most important part is the configuration here. Since it's a config server, so most important part is the configurations. So let's see how we will configure our config server to be able to bind with some location. So as we said in this, for this example, we are binding it to native, that means file system, like local file system. This dependency management, I'm showing it again so that you can, if you are doing with me, so you can pause it and you can see it. So as I have shown, we have added at enable config server. So this is the annotation which makes our application as a config server, and we have added that. And same thing we have shown in the tutorial also, Spring IO tutorial also. And this is our local YAML file. So we are starting on the port 8888, and this configuration we have seen in the tutorial, like profiles.active, there we need to say native, and cloud config server native search location. Here we need to say that which location are we will be reading the properties from, so that we are saying. And then application name we need to set, so we are simply saying config server. The main thing here is the line number 11, where we are actually pointing our application to some particular search location. And here in this case, in our case, search location is a config folder we have created under users, and then this location, at this location. So whatever files we will place under this location, they all will be read through this config server. and it will inject those properties into our client services. So yeah, as I mentioned earlier also, this Belding site is very good. So here also they are showing how to do this configurations. So same again, it is showing. So now we are starting with the client service. So our client is a simple config client, and we are having the dependency as Spring Cloud starter config. So this starter when we add this starter config, it is actually referring to cloud config client. Okay, so that is the one thing, and the other thing is the dependency starter actuator dependency. So actuator is actually providing the management endpoints for our service. Okay, so that's what it's going to do. And this is the effective POM, as we can see. Although Lombok we have added, but here it will not be needed much. And these are the dependencies we are going to have here. And the same dependency management section we have added here also for Spring Cloud configurations. Config client here. This is the client code, and this is the application YAML of the local client. So, and we are having a property called say hello user and refresh scope. Refresh scope, as I mentioned in the previous previous section, so that we have added here. And we have this say hello user in the local also, and the same copy we will have in the config server locations property file or property YAML. Okay, so this value we should be able to, if everything is fine, then instead of RAM we should be able to read the value whatever returned there in this hello config dot hello config settings dot YAML. This is the location actually. This file is present in the config server search locations. Okay, so this is the file, and hello greetings dot YAML. Sorry. And the YAML files which we placed under that search location folder, they should have the same name as the their corresponding service names. So since the service in context currently is the hello greetings service, so that's what we are having here, hello greetings.yaml. So whenever we refresh through actuator endpoint, our service will fetch from the config server hello greetings.yaml file. and it will load this particular property, say dot hello dot user, and currently there it is, the message is like and share. Okay, so if everything is fine, we should be getting the message saying like and share. And before to that, client configurations are, we need to set the application name as the reason I have already told, and we are having hello greetings as the service name, spring.application name. And cloud config URI we need to mention, like as to what is the config server we should be referring to here in this case. So that property is important, and then this config import is also important. So we have added those properties, config import and config cloud config URI. And this management endpoint, we need to add this particular property because we are enabling that refresh scope. Okay, and actuator endpoint, since we are including actuator endpoints here, so we need to expose them. So that exposition part we are doing through this YAML file. Okay, and we are running this particular service under on port 8090. So that's it, guys. So we should be, if everything is fine, we should be reading in this get mapping. We should be getting the greet user will be having the same message, whatever message we are, you know, having. So we will be returning simply hello and greet user as the message. So greet user would be simply having the message here. Here, although I took the variable names which are not matching, but ideally we should keep the variable names which matches with the context. Okay, so that gives a good readability, so we should always keep those things in mind. So I am bouncing the servers. First I am bouncing the config server, and then I will bounce my client also. So config server is starting on 8888, and similarly, yeah, it is started. Now I'm starting hello greetings, which is my client, config client. So that also we are starting here. Let's see if everything is fine. We should be able to hit it from browser, from our browser Chrome. So yeah, the server is started, and as you can see, the server is started and it is showing the actuator endpoints. Yes, Tomcat started at port 8090. Context path we haven't configured, all our main part is that only, I mean our main path is default path, that is slash 8090 slash. So once we hit that, we should be able to get the message from config server, and we should be showing that here. And in this is our config server. So as you can see here, it is showing we are reading this particular hello greetings.yaml in config server. This is config server logs. So here, as you can see in the log, it is showing we are reading that location, and we are reading hello greetings.yaml. So that property will be injected from this hello greetings.yaml. So this is the path, I mean for our config server. So whenever we give this URL, we should be able to it will show like from which location it is currently reading, and what is the current value of at that location, those things it will be showing. Okay, so this URL is showing that part, like the location of my location of my YAML file from where I will be injecting those properties into my client. So client name is hello greetings, and for that hello greetings we will be referring hello greetings.yaml at the search locations, which is present at the search location. And the value of say hello.user is that like and share, so it is showing that. So far so good. Now we will try to hit at 8090 and see what it should be showing there. So at 8090, as you can see, it is showing like and share, which is the current value at the location, as the search location, at the search location hello greetings.yaml. And now we are refreshing, as I said, the curl command. So this is the curl command we will provide in the description section also. So this is the curl command, and once we hit this curl command, our server, our client service will be refreshed, and it should start reading from that particular location property, from that particular location, from config server. Whatever is coming in config server will be injected here. So that's what we are going to do. So once we run, it shows like the property which is changed. So yeah, currently since we have not changed, let's change something and then refresh the scope. So that's what we are going to do. So now here in this YAML, let's say something, let's say like share and subscribe. So yes, do support our work if you like it, and share it with your friends and colleagues, because many people would be facing issues related to this. So if we can share these things with our friends, they will also get to do these things. So as you can see now, config server, it is reflecting, the values are reflecting in config server, but here 8090 at that location is still not, it's still the old value. So once we hit it, once we hit the curl command again, and with this curl command, now it should read from this the updated value. It should say like share and subscribe also, apart from just like and share. Even the system is also asking you to subscribe. Jokes apart, so now refresh has happened. We'll hit again the same URL, we will refresh it. Yes, as you can see, after refresh, scope refresh, now in the L name it is showing that value, the message. So that's what today's tutorial is all about. Okay, we will try some more things here, like we can say our ambition. So we are saying target 100k. I'm repeating again. Target 100k subs, and when I refresh, it should refresh that as well. So that's it guys, that's for today's session. That's all in today's session. We will come up with some more topics in cloud config. Definitely we will cover one by one all the 12 factors. That's all, we are refreshing it, and the system also should say what we want. Now we are going to hit it again. Yes, so even our system is also saying that target 100k subs. So that can only happen with your support. Please do support us, please spread your love and support to us. Thanks for watching with this, and until next time, bye bye, have a nice life, stay safe at home, and enjoy life.
Khatam. Bye bye, tata, goodbye, gaya.